Hi, this is Phillip with Ascendix Technologies. Today I'm going to show you how to modify the Create New Record button up top and make modifications to an existing Create New Record like contacts, or create a custom button for a custom object or for a specific record type for an existing object. So in the case where you have multiple account record types, you can make the changes like this. So to get started, let's go ahead and jump into your Salesforce instance, and be sure to be logged in as an administrator to perform the following steps. So go ahead and click on the gear icon here, and then select setup, then type in global actions, and then once you're at global actions, you'll want to select the object that you want to make changes to. In my system, there are multiple kind of global actions here with a similar name, but I do know the one I want to modify is this top one here for contacts. So if we go and look at the contact global action, there's a couple things that are positioned in a way where I don't want them to be. So let's just say, yeah, name, title, and relationship type is fine, but I want account name below title when I'm creating a record. So I can do that here. And if I wanted to add something like a do not call or email opt out button or option or field to the record, I can. And I'll go ahead and hit save. So what that'll do is directly update my list here. If it doesn't show up initially when I hit on new contact, all I have to do is go ahead and refresh. So you can see this is the old layout that was being utilized. So all I have to do is quickly close out of it and then reopen it. And this will reload the sidebar. And then now when I create a new contact, you'll see the fields are arranged first last name. So that was just one name field, a title, account name, relationship type, that's fine. Do not call, email opt out. So all those things will show up now after that refresh. Okay, so the second thing is, how do I add my own global action or record creation button here into the Outlook integration? Well, pretty much the same thing, except in this instance, you'll be creating new action. And then for the action type, you want to set it to create a record. And then the target object is the object that you want to create a record for. So let's look for deals, because I have multiple record types for this. So this is a good way to demonstrate this next part. So I need to select a specific record type for this button. Due to the nature of how these things work, if you have multiple record types that you need to create buttons for, you have to do them individually. You can't just switch between multiple ones using one action. So you would have to create multiple ones. Okay, so now we just need to title this. Okay, once you have this all set up, you can add a description, but in this case, I'm not going to. So now that I've have this button created, I need to add some fields to it. So let's just say I want deal stage, and then I want, let's see, is there anything I want? Yeah. So let's also put in a status field here. And property type. Just some basics that I want to cover here. So now that I've saved everything, I need to make it available, because if we come over here and just reload this, you'll notice that this global action is actually not available here yet. So you will need to go to the home tab here and then type in Outlook. Now click on Outlook integration and sync. From Outlook integration, go ahead and expand it out, and then scroll down until you see something called email application publisher layouts. And then from here, select your default one, or if you don't have one, go ahead and create a new one. Okay, for me, I have an existing one, so I'll click on edit. And then you can see these are outlined in a way that's displayed here. So let's go ahead and make a couple changes here. Let's say I don't need new sale and new lease inquiry, but I do want to add the new consulting deal as well as the new cases. So I can do that and go ahead and hit save. So now that I've saved, I can come back into my Outlook and then close out of this panel and then just refresh it by opening it back up again. And then now you can see I've those changes I've made are available now. And if I were to click on new consulting deal, you'll see the deal name as well as the deal stage. And if you see something that isn't appearing here, like in my scenario, it's because I have actually set it up. I've actually set up some fields that aren't actually visible on this profile. So for that reason, those fields aren't showing up. But this is something that you can troubleshoot in case certain fields don't show up. Let's go back and just quickly modify the global action again. And then go down to my new consulting deal layout. And then I can go ahead and remove the fields that don't apply to me. Okay, let's select something like actual value, buyer and buyer contact. And then I'll just quick save this. And now if we hop back over to Outlook here, let me just close out of that pane and just completely refresh it. And then if I click on new consulting, oops, sometimes it does take a moment for everything to load up. So let's do that again. And you can see the fields are showing up correctly. So you have deal name, deal stage, actual value, buyer, buyer contact. If we look back here, that's what we have here as well. All right. Thank you all for your time. Hope this helps.